Hey everyone, it's Israel Ramos here at campus in East Lansing, Michigan. I want to talk a little bit about protest. It's something that's been going on in the news quite a bit, happening all around us. And the question that comes to my mind is, how should the Christian protest? Now, if you're an American citizen, or if you live in a country that has freedoms, as we do here in the United States, it is a privilege of the citizens of our country to exercise their freedom to protest. And protesting simply means making a statement or an action that it disapproves of what's going on. The question that I have in my mind that I'm wrestling with at this time is, how should the Christian protest? One of the strongest protests that Jesus makes in Scripture is the Sermon on the Mount that is found in Matthew chapter 5. And there Jesus opens his mouth, teaches the multitudes, and he shares something that is drastically different from what is being taught at that time. He says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are those who are persecuted. These were not just nice sayings of comfort to the people who are listening, but they're actually statements of protest. And it has impacted me in the way that I've thought about what should I as a Christian, not as an American only, but as a Christian, what should I do in my life to protest against the injustice that is done in the world today through racism or against gender equality or against whatever it is that is happening in our world today. And what has impacted me is the fact that the Bible in and of itself is a protest. It is essentially a guide that goes against, that protests against my human nature to live. It is in Scripture that I find a counter influence to the way in which I want to think or to the way in which I want to act. And I'm saddened by the idea that in many cases we believe that Scripture or that the gospel is not enough. We believe that we need more than the gospel in terms of meeting the injustices of the world today. I want to put this thought before you, that there is no more radical person than the person of Jesus Christ. Crazy enough to come to this world and to die for my sins and yours. And there is no radical message, no stronger message of protest than the message that says you need a transformation of yourself in order to make this world a better place. And so I leave you with that thought this week, this thought on protest. What are your thoughts about it? Should the Christian protest? Is there any greater protest, any greater power to protest than the power of Scripture, transformation of the life, and the radical person of Jesus Christ? Let us know.